Disney Queen Skelly here. I did promise that I would tell you guys the story about how all my tattoos kind of came to be and how they happened. I don't know. I will tell you this, I don't remember how most of them came to be, but they all do come with some sort of interesting story that I remember. So we're going to start with this one right here, the top one. So it's my grandfather's name, his birthday, and then the day he passed away. That was my first ever tattoo, and I got it at the age of 19 after I had saved up a bit when I got my first job. Now, I didn't know that, like, a tattoo font app existed at the time, which I have now in order to do my tattoo fonts, but back then I had no idea. So I had my ex do some, like, calligraphy and try to, like, write it all pretty, and he made like three options for me, so I picked that one because it was the prettiest. I went to go get it done alone. I think that was the only one I ever did alone. Other than the Fall Out Boy tattoo, but I think that was the only one I did alone. I think other than that, I had someone with me. Even if he was with me, I don't remember, and honestly, what does that tell you? Anyway, so I got that one, and then I came home with it. My dad wasn't too happy. And then I kid you not, like 3 months later, I came home with this tattoo. It is faded. I need to get it touched up, but it's a uterine cancer ribbon with my aunt's name and the word survivor because she is a uterine cancer survivor. And I came home with that. My dad wasn't too happy. My friend Jeremy actually came with me. Hi, Jeremy. And I was so, like, I had planned to get it in advance, and it's like a $60 deposit to hold your place, and I asked them if that was included with the price or if it was separate, and they told me it was included. Now, in my mind, I'm thinking, okay, that deducted like $60 from my tattoo. Well, I went to go get it, and I was $20 short, and I was like, oh, hell. So I looked at Jeremy, I'm like, hey, can you help me out? I'll pay you back. So he helped me out, thankfully. And then I came home with that. Dad wasn't too happy. My grandfather didn't say anything, thankfully. And then I got my leg tattoo. Now, this one, I was actually able to hide it for a while. And around this time, I actually had a roommate who was living with me at the time. And she ended up getting in her first car wreck that day. And so I had worn shorts to bed. And I ran out to her and I was like, are you okay? Not realizing my dad was the one who had picked her up and taken her home. He found it, and then he basically admitted to me that day that he wasn't gonna care either way if I got a tattoo, that it was my body and I would have to suffer the consequences with getting one. And I'm over here thinking, like, look, I know what I put on my body, and it's not like I just got this idea and decided to get it. I held on to it for a while and then got it. So, I mean, you know, it's not like I'm over here looking at a picture of a freaking, like, Coca-Cola vanilla chapstick and thinking, wow, this is a great tattoo idea, and then going to go get it. So I keep these as ideas for a while until I actually go get them. Now, with my Jack one, that was the one that actually hurt the most because of the location. So I ended up having hubby with me when I got it. And oh my god, was it painful. I actually had Harley baby with me when I got the leg tattoo. But I had hubby with me when I got this tattoo right here. And it did not feel good. I was squeezing his hand, pretty much puncturing skin. And he can't be mad at me there because it did hurt. And it was funny because she had finished it, but then she was putting some finishing touches on it. And I'm over here thinking, ow, 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 ow. And she's like, well, do you want it to look pretty? I'm like, yes, please. So she starts doing some finishing touches on it. And, you know, she eventually finished. And this was the hardest one to take care of because I don't have a lot of shirts that come, like, that kind of cut off here. A lot of mine are V-necks. So trying to cover this, take care of it, keep it away from the sun was an absolute pain in the ass. But yeah, those are the stories of all of my tattoos that I can kind of remember. I know they're short, so that's why I just packed them into one video. But you guys already know the story about the Fall Out Boy tattoo. So now that you're all caught up, whenever I get new tattoos, I will tell you guys the story of what happened. And hopefully those will be a little bit longer because I'll do it either the day of or maybe a couple days later. So that way you guys, you know, get a fresh story. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys have any tattoos, let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to know how many My Little Skeletons there out there are inked and how inked you are. Anyways, bye little skeletons. Stay safe. I love you guys.